Welcome to the session of simulation of the full wave rectifier using LTSpice software. These are the learning outcome of the session. In this session, we are going to simulate the full wave rectifier with the resistive load and the full wave rectifier with the resistive and capacitive load. Before proceeding, let me ask you one question. Why the half wave rectifiers are generally not used in a DC power supply? You may pause the video, think on the question, you can resume the video in order to see the answer. Let me give the answer. Now with the half wave rectifier, the output voltage is zero for the half period of the time. It means that during the negative half cycle, the output is zero. So the type of the supply available from the half wave rectifier is not satisfactory for the general power supply. That is why it is not generally used as a DC power supply. Let us see the simulation of full wave rectifier in LTSpice software. Before proceeding, let us see what is the full wave rectifier. As shown in figure, it consists of four diodes which are connected in a bridge configuration. As shown in figure, during the positive half cycle, these two diodes are conducting. As a result, the output is available, and during the negative half cycle, these two diodes are conducting, and thus we will get the output. In this way, for the both positive and negative half cycle, the two diodes are conducting. As a result, we will get the output DC power supply. But you can see here, the output consists of the ripples. In order to remove these ripples, you can use the capacitor. So this is a full wave rectifier with the RC load. As you can see that due to the addition of the capacitor in the circuit, the results output waveform having the less ripples. So this is the previous waveform having the ripples, which is without capacitor, and this is the new waveform having no ripples or less ripples as compared to the previous output. So this happens because of the charging and discharging of the capacitor. As you see from figure, during this session the capacitor discharges, and during this session the capacitor charges. Because of this charging and discharging of the capacitor, the waveform does not go to the zero. So during this session, the resistive capacitor discharges through the resistive load, and again for this session the capacitor charges. Now we have to simulate these two waveforms in the LTSpice software. So let us see that. So this is the environment where we are going to draw the schematic of the circuit. So here we have different options available. So let us use this option component. So by using this option, you can add the component to your circuit. So first component that we will need is the diode. So search for the diode. Here is the diode. So click on OK. In order to rotate, you can press Ctrl R. So let us add the four diodes. In order to select the diode number, just go to move your cursor over that diode and then right click and pick a new diode. From this, there are many options are available in the library. You can select the appropriate diode. I will select the diode 1N4148. Click on OK. Similarly, for second diode, right click and pick up a new diode, select 1N4148. And similarly for the remaining two diodes. In this way, we have selected the diode. Now connect these diodes together by using the wires. Now let us add the voltage source. So click on the component, right here voltage, and press OK. So here I will add the voltage source. Then let us add the transformer at the input. For the transformer, I will add the two inductors. So this is one inductor and another. By rotating that inductor, I will add the another inductor, that is L2. So we have the two inductors L1 and L2. The L1 inductor will act as an input. So let us connect this L1 inductor to the supply voltage. So in this way I will connect the inductor L1 to the supply, and inductor L2 will act as a secondary of the transformer, which will be given as an input to the diodes. Then press escape. Now let us add the resistor at the output. So here is a symbol of the resistor. Add the resistor at the output and then connect this resistor by using the wire. So this is the circuit diagram of the full wave rectifier. Let us add the ground. So here is the symbol of the ground. Click on that symbol and here is the ground, and here I will add the another ground at the input. Now these two inductors works as only the inductors before they are coupled with each other. In order to act these two inductors as a transformer, we have to couple these two inductors. So we have to use the command. So here is an option which we can write the command, which is written as spice directive. Click on that option and I will use the command capital K, the name of the inductor L1, so another is L2 and 1. So this command stands for, there is a coupling between the, K stands for the coupling between the inductor L1 and L2 with the less noise. 1 stands for there is a no losses in between the two coupling. So here I will add. You can see that after the coupling we have here, there are two bubbles are appeared. So these inform us that there is a coupling in between the two inductor. Now let us give the values to the inductor. Right click on that inductor and give the value 1 mH, and for the another inductor right click, give the value 2 mH. Let us give the supply voltage. Right click on that supply voltage and go to the advanced. I will say select the sinusoidal input, DC offset 0, amplitude select 5 volt and frequency you can select the 50. Input resistance I will give 0.1 mΩ as a resistor. So give the output value to the resistor, right click on that resistor and give the value 1K. So here is a complete schematic of the full wave rectifier using the LTSpice software. In order to simulate that, go to the option simulate, go to the option edit simulation command, and here I will add the simulation stop time as 50 milliseconds and click OK. So the transition time is of the 50 milliseconds. So go to the option run and click that. So let us observe the input first. So here is an input, so the sinusoidal input given, and let us observe the output, and here is the output. So the blue output represents the output of the full wave rectifier and the green represent the input to the full wave rectifier. So this output is with the resistive load, not the capacitive load. So we have not added the capacitor yet. So this is the output because of the resistance, and you can see that there are many ripples are present in the output. So in order to get the DC output, we have to add the capacitor. So I will close this window. I will maximize this window. Let us add the capacitor and let us see what is the effect of adding the capacitor at the output. So here is the capacitor, select that capacitor and let us add that capacitor across this section. Click on that, and in order to add the wire, you can click on here and add the wire. And then escape. Let us give the value of the capacitor as 10. U stands for micro. Let us run the simulation. Now this is the input and now this is the output. You can observe that the capacitor will charge during this session and discharge during the session via the resistor. So because of the charging and discharging, this waveform having a less ripples as compared to the previous waveform. If you increase the capacitance, what is the effect? Let us see that. If I use 100 microfarad, what is the effect of that capacitance? You can see that you will get a more smooth DC at the output. If you change the value of the capacitor from 10 microfarad to 100 microfarad, the DC ripples which is present in the output, DC output, will be the less as compared to the previous. So in this way, by using the RC component at the output, we can have a smooth DC waveform with the less ripples in the output. So in this way we have created the schematic using the LTSpice software for the full wave rectifier with the resistive load and RC load, and simulated that in LTSpice, and we have seen what is the effect of adding the capacitance and changing that value of the capacitance from 10 microfarad to 100 microfarad. These are the references for the session. Thank you.